Eddie Posner. Now that global warming has finally become a mainstream issue, we hear a lot about renewable energy such as wind, solar, like this little solar charger I have here, geothermal, hydroelectric, and even nuclear as alternatives to solve the problem. We also hear a lot about the potential of hydrogen and fuel cells to power our cars and homes. But we are told that this technology is decades away. Well, while it's true that the technology still needs to be improved, the fact of the matter is that there are small numbers of cars being powered by hydrogen and fuel cells in cities today all around the world, and a university in Los Angeles, California already has a hydrogen fuel cell power plant that's generating 1 megawatt of clean energy. I met with Bill Sullivan, the energy manager at California State University Northridge, to talk about the power plant and how it works.
Okay, yeah, we're here at California State University where we've just installed a 1 megawatt fuel cell. We have four individual 250 kilowatt fuel cells to make that 1 megawatt. It's run on natural gas, and there's a reforming process that goes on inside the stack, which is the cylindrical part you see behind me. And that turns the natural gas into a hydrogen, and the hydrogen is used in a chemical reaction to create electricity. The exhaust that comes out of these is about 700 degrees, and we're using that heat. We're recovering it up in our exhaust in a heat exchanger and dumping that into our heating hot water loop. Eventually, in the future, we'll also have a second coil that's going to be providing heating hot water and water for the swimming, hot water for the swimming pool and the student union across the sidewalk. This project was done all in-house with all of our own people. The purchasing, the installation, all the concrete, all the metalwork, piping for the heating, the heat recovery, and the light was all done by our own people on the campus. And it was a really great project. And the exhaust that comes out of these is almost entirely just CO2 and water. And we could use landfill gas to feed these if we could get some here. Compared to coal-fired power plants, this is a considerably more efficient system. We are about 43% efficient just on the electrical side. We end up about 80% by the time we use the heat for recovering also, whereas a coal-fired power plant is about 33% efficient, so we have much better efficiency for the amount of exhaust that we have. This is called the stack. It's very warm. This is where the electrochemical reaction happens. It's about 1200 degrees in there, and they have all the fuel cell parts stacked up. And that's where the hydrogen is removed, and then the electrochemical reaction making electricity happens in there. This part over here is called the mechanical balance plant. That has all the mechanical parts for the operation. It's got blowers, it's got reverse osmosis, the control system is in there. And the last part, which is back over here, is called the electrical balance of plant. That's the inverter. That's where the DC is converted to AC, and then it's dumped onto our power grid and used from here. Okay, one of the amazing things I always think about this operation is how quiet it is, considering we're making 1 megawatt of electricity. The loudest thing we have is our exhaust fan, where we combine the exhaust from the units together. And it also takes a very small footprint to make all of this. We're about, I think, 100 feet by 40 feet is all that this takes up to make 1 megawatt of power. Yeah, we'll talk about our heat recovery side of this. You'll see up here the exhaust leaving one of the units. Comes up, we combine all four exhaust flows from each of the 250 kilowatt fuel cells. And they're all combined right there. And then we have a fan that pulls that exhaust up onto the roof, and that's where it goes through our two heat exchangers. That will be the first one. We're taking the 700-degree air and bringing it down to about 190, and we're taking that heating hot water, which is coming out at about 250 degrees, into our heating hot water loop. And when the second part of the project is complete, we're going to be providing heating hot water for the swimming pool across the street and the student union, as well as their domestic heating hot water. And this is where the fuel is fed into the system from the gas company, and it's then pushed into the fuel cell, into the stack itself, which is where the reforming takes place, which is where it's converted into hydrogen. These are the greenhouses behind me for the biology department, and some of the exhaust will be used for carbon enrichment testing if they want to do that, because the plants are supposed to grow faster with a richer carbon dioxide environment. And we'll be talking in a minute about our subtropical rainforest that we're going to be putting the rest of the exhaust into. This is the site of the subtropical rainforest I mentioned previously that we're going to be dumping a lot of the exhaust in what's called a free air carbon enrichment system, and that should help our rainforest grow faster. And the reason why we're doing a subtropical rainforest is because we're also collecting the condensate from the exhaust stream, and that's going to be a considerable amount of water, as well as the processed water from the fuel cells themselves. So we're going to have a lot of water, and we're going to make use of that here with plants that like a wet environment. And we're also going to be putting some cooling towers in here for some chillers that we're going to be putting in very close to here, and that's going to help keep the temperature up and the humidity levels higher in the general area. By dumping the CO2 into this subtropical rainforest, that should sequester some of the CO2, which means we won't be dumping as much into the environment after it's all said and done.
Though this plant uses natural gas to produce hydrogen, it represents a significant step away from traditional fossil fuel energy, because no fossil fuels are actually being burned. These are the power plants of the future. The only difference is that the hydrogen will be generated from landfill gas or through electrolysis using renewable energy. And the best part is that the technology is available today, and it works.